Welcome to section 9.9, model relationships. Now, the thing with this whole section is that as we are modeling relationships, we are looking at how to use those three different types of functions that we have worked with before in real world scenarios. Those three different functions being linear, quadratic, or exponential. And I'll try to give you some hints as to how to recognize which is which as well. So the first one, we have the water from a water cannon on a firefighting boat reaches a maximum height of 25 feet. I'm just gonna stop there for a second because I'm seeing that word maximum height. When we're talking about a linear equation or a linear graph, it keeps going in a straight line for forever. There's no maximum. When we're working with an exponential graph, it either starts pretty much at zero and goes up and doesn't have a maximum, or it starts pretty close to zero and goes down, but it doesn't actually have a maximum. It just never finishes getting closer to zero. So none of those end up actually having a maximum. So the only type of relationship that would have a maximum for what we have done before is a quadratic, where we have that upside down U shape. So that's one way that you can just figure out right away what type of equation we're working with. Another way you can know that that's the one we'd be working with is that whenever we talk about things that are being thrown or projected or something where gravity plays a function, gravity makes all of our shapes related to it a quadratic. It's going to give us that parabola or that parabolic shape. So that's another way you could know that this would be a quadratic. So it has a maximum height of 25 feet and travels a horizontal distance of 140 feet. What type of function represents the path? Well, we know the type of function would be a quadratic. Oops, didn't mean to zoom in. Helps if I'm not writing with an eraser. Quadratic. Given this context, what do the intercepts and the maximum point represent? Well, if you think about it, I'm going to change the color for this one. What our arc is doing here is this is the stream of water that's being shot out. So that means this intercept right here is where it's getting shot out of the cannon or the starting point. Here is going to be where it ends up landing. So that would be the finishing point. And ideally, since we're trying to put out a fire with this, hopefully that fire is there at the finishing point. Sort of depends on how well they're actually aiming their firefighter cannon, but that's the goal. And then as far as the maximum point, that's going to be the highest point of the water's arc. So where it sort of gets to that point where it stops going up and starts going down. So at that point, it has, like, all of the changes is all because of gravity. None of the force that's still there is because of the force of the cannon. So that's kind of cool. So other things we might be asked to do in this section, to figure out which equation is increasing faster. Well, first we have a function that our x-intercept is at 4 and our y-intercept is at -2. So if we go and graph this, I'm going to interpret this as it will be a straight line. So our x-intercept is at 1, 2, 3, 4. Y-intercept is at -2. So that means our slope would be going up to right 4. So we'd have a slope of 1/2. Now, looking at the second function, hopefully this is also a linear function because otherwise it's hard to figure out how it's increasing. But fortunately also, our x's keep going up by 1s. And for our y's, this one goes up by 5. This one goes up by 5, up by 5. So that one's being consistent as well, so it has to be a linear function. Well, our change in y, it's going up by 5, over our change in x is going up by 1. So this one has a slope of 5. So which is increasing faster? Has to be function 2. Its slope is larger. Now we can also figure out which one has the lowest minimum value. And I just realized I didn't put in any lines on function 2 to help us figure out how low that is. So hopefully we're the function one is clear enough that function two is easier to interpret. So remember, to find that vertex, we need to find the line of symmetry, which is at negative b over 2a. Well, our b is negative 12, so negative of negative 12 over 2 times 3 gives a positive 12 over 6, or an x value of 2. Now, if we go and plug that back in so we can actually get the point of our vertex, we would have a 3 times 2 squared minus 12 times 2 plus 1. Well, 2 squared is 4, times 3 makes that 12, minus 12 times 2 would be 24. So 12 minus 24 would be negative 12, plus 1 would be negative 11. So that means we'd have a point at 2, negative 11. And I bet what I meant to do with function 2 was, when I graphed this, I had lines here. So looking at this, with what my original graph was, this is supposed to be at 1, 2, and at 1, 2. So our point here is a lot higher up than that negative 11. So that means this one has the lowest value. So it has to be function 1. Sorry about not including the correct lines on that. That was a little confusing. Now let's go and figure out what type of model fits this data. Well, as you can see, our x's keep going up by 1, so that's nice. Our y's, we go up by 1.5. And then here we go up by just under 2. So I'll say about 2. About 1.5. Not about 2, about 1.5. And then here, this is about 1.6. And here we are up to about 1.8. So it's not increasing by the same amount every time. We can look at that second level to see how that changes. So here it goes changed by about 0, by about 0.1, by about 0.2. Well, that tells us it's not going to be quadratic, because these are not the same in the second tier. The first tier ones are not the same, so it can't be linear. So just by the process of deduction, by what we know so far, this has to be exponential. Now let's try another one. You are a furniture salesperson and you earn $200 a week. Sweet. So let's say my salary is equal to $200 a week plus 5% commission on sales. So plus 0.05 times my commission. What type of function models this? Well, I just found the equation for this, and that type of equation, this is a linear equation. So it has to be a linear function to model this. And that's it. That's all the more I've got for you for today. So good luck. This should be similar to what you did last section. And if you do have any questions, make sure you let me know.